properties of solid. There are five: paramagnetism, diamagnetism, ferromagnetism, antimaferro, and ferri. First of all, paramagnetism. What is paramagnetism? It is a paramagnetic substance are weakly attracted by magnetic field. Weakly attracted. If the substances are weakly attracted, then it is known as paramagnetism. And these are magnetic field in the same direction. Magnetized in a magnetic field. In a magnetic field in the same direction. In the same direction. Okay. If there are weakly attracted, then it is known paramagnetism. And magnetism in the field in the same direction, if the direction will be same, okay, that means these are paramagnetism. And they lost their magnetism in the absence of a magnetic field. So example which shows paramagnetism behavior: O2, copper 2+, Fe3+, Cr3+, these type of substances, they show paramagnetism. Why? Because they have unpaired electron. N value will be 1, 2, 3. These are known as unpaired electron. Okay, if unpaired electron is present, then it is known as paramagnetism. Like paramagnetism, diamagnetism also present. Diamagnetism are weakly repelled. Weakly repelled. Attracted, if it is substances are attracted, weakly attracted, paramagnetism. Weakly repelled, that means it is diamagnetism. Example are H2, NaCl, also benzene, C6HCl, shows diamagnetism behavior. And the magnetism in the magnetic field in our opposite in direction. One is upward, one is downward. So it is opposite in direction. And electrons are paired. Electrons are paired. Ferromagnetism is strongly attracted. Okay, example, metal like iron, cobalt, this type of metal, iron, cobalt, nickel, they show ferromagnetism behavior. Because in solid state, the metal and ferromagnetic substance are grouped together in small region. Ferromagnetic substance are grouped into small group together into small region. Okay, this region is called as domain. What is domain? If the ferromagnetic substance group together into small, so when a substance is placed near a magnetic field, here it is magnetic field, a substance is near to magnetic field, then domains get oriented. These are same direction. Okay, this is known as domain. These are strongly attracted metal and this substance group together into small region. These are called domains. When the magnetic field near place to the substance, then domains get oriented. If domains are present in opposite direction, here domains are present in same direction, but here if domains are present in opposite direction, okay, one is upward, one is downward, one is upward, one is downward, like this. If the domains are present in opposite direction, these are known as antiferromagnetism, and same behavior like ferromagnetism. And these are example having MnO2, V2O3, Mn2O3, this type of molecule MnO shows antiferromagnetism. Ferromagnetism and antiferromagnetism, these are strongly attracted. But it is same direction, but it is opposite in direction. Opposite means anti, same means only ferro. Examples are FeCO, nickel like metal, but here's oxide form MnO2, V2O3, like that. Ferromagnetism, when domains are aligned one line in parallel or in parallel and in anti-parallel, parallel or anti-parallel in own equal number. If the present is parallel, aligned in parallel and anti-parallel, all equal number means 2 is upward, 1 is downward, 2 is upward, 1 is downward. That means they are aligned in parallel or anti-parallel, on equal number. No equal number opposite direction. It is 2, it is 1. On equal, parallel and anti-parallel direction are present. And these type of ferrimagnetism shown by Fe3, U4, Mg, Fe2, U4, these are also known as spinel.